Autumn, you confronted really Justin Trudeau a couple of years ago about water protection, issues around water protection. Did he listen to you? Do you feel he listened to you? And what's happened on that front since?
Well, I can't exactly... Well, since then, I feel like I made an impact on children that are younger than me and older than me. And I feel that I've seen a lot more youth standing up. And I feel like me doing that kind of maybe even gave them the courage to, like, you know, use their voice. Because I was only 12 when that happened. And I think that really, that was really empowering for me, actually. And then when I look at it from, I guess you could say, Canadian perspective, since I've done that, I feel like there has been change, because the Canadian government actually, well, his Canadian government is actually working really hard towards trying to resolve the boil water advisories in First Nations communities. And since then, I know it was one of their goals, I guess, and it was to resolve the boil water advisories, and he is doing that. But the only issue with that is every time one is resolved, a new one occurs. So it's kind of continuous. But I know in Canada they are trying to make change.
One of the questions on my mind is you know, how you go from protests and panels to policy change. And you've got a formal role now, right? Will you tell the audience about, you've got a seat at the table in a sense, yeah.
Well, I'm the Chief Water Commissioner for Anishinaabek Nation, and basically what Anishinaabek Nation is the Indigenous people in Ontario, and that's kind of the form of Indigenous government there. And so basically my Auntie Josephine Mandamin, she was the Chief Water Commissioner prior to me before she passed away, and they felt that it was best that they passed the role on to me as I was following in her footsteps and doing her work. And so what the role really is advocating for the Great Lakes in Canada, well, not exactly all in Canada, but advocating for the Great Lakes and kind of having a say at the table when decisions are made for them. And so that's kind of what my role is.
Do you always trust your first initial feeling? Special knowledge holds truth, bears believing. I turned around and the water was closing all around, like a glove, like the love that had
talking about climate change. There's, of course, broad public support for action, but as Greta was saying earlier, nothing's happening with emissions. What if not this, the work you're doing and that others around the world are doing to bring attention to this, what will it take to actually, do you think, see change in the numbers?
Well, to see change, I think that what we need to do is start getting more people and more youth, not only from Canada, but from all over the world, and empowering other kids to stand up like how we are. And I think that what we're doing right now is empowering them, because being at the World Economic Forum, we're on a global stage, and everyone's gonna be watching this, and what we say right now is gonna make an impact on everyone watching. And so, like, even for me, people are awarding me for, oh, you're doing such a great job, but I don't want your awards. If you're gonna award me with helping me find solutions, award me with helping me make change. And I feel that's what I would wanna see, is more people trying to help us with what we're trying to achieve.
Autumn, you have thoughts on the role of the media in amplifying your work or these issues that what anybody have experienced, positive or negative, with people like me?
Well, I think media is a really big part of the work we do, because a lot of it is online, and I just think that when it comes to people that are, I just want to say this one thing, is like, if you have negative things to say online to us, just don't even try and do that. Like, it's so wrong, and we're just trying to do good things. And if you have negative comments about it, just please don't, like, try and, I don't know, say this to us, because we're just trying to do good things. And that's the thing, is that there's always going to be negative people and positive people online, and we're really just trying to maybe even change the minds of the people that think negatively about the things we do. So yeah, I just think that media does have a really big impact on what we do.
Autumn, the wind blows colder than summer. So I guess I'll stay here in New England for autumn, autumn. The buildings look tall and gray. The birds flying have much to say. They all know coming again, so I guess they'll stay here in New England for autumn. Did you ever lose something that you thought you knew?
Autumn, what are you, who's listening and who's not listening?
Well, I personally don't feel like that heard from politicians, I would say. My local members of parliament, I do feel really heard because, for example, Michael Mantha, he's the MP of Algoma Manitoulin, and he's doing a lot of work to help me achieve my goals and around that area. And then, like, even Carolyn Bennett, she's doing a lot of stuff to help me be heard as well. But then when it comes to federal government, it's really hard to get their attention, be heard by them, because honestly, I would say they're all focused on just money. And we need to be more focused on the actual things going on, and that they're not thinking about the impacts and things that are happening. Like, it's almost like they don't even believe that climate change is real. Like, we all say climate change is a real thing, and they're not realizing that. And basically what we're all trying to do is convince them, trying to tell them they need to listen to us. And I just feel being a youth, we're not as heard as we can be in our potential. So.
You gotta do what you do, don't what you don't.
We'll win.
Will when you will, and won't when you won't.
Want another run at that? Do what you do.
Do what you do, don't what you don't.
We'll win.
Will when you will, and won't when you won't.
Nice.
Some of us were born to dance, others are too shy. Some feet like to tap their toes, others like to fly. Natural, awkward, and wild. Everybody wants to move, and everyone's got style. You gotta do what you do, don't what you don't. Will when you will, and won't when you won't. Some people choose their words with care, and others say anything. Some folks like to talk a lot, while others speak within. Confident and bold, everybody's got a voice, and every voice.
You know, we've talked a lot about the inspiration and hope you're bringing to others, but obviously there's a flip side to that. And what can we all learn from all of you about how you deal with the haters?
Well, for me, me and my mom do get a lot of negativity, and what we do is we just ignore it, because you know that's their own opinion, and it's not really our problem, because what we're trying to do is positive, and we're all trying to do is positive. So I just think that ignoring it's probably just the best way to go. Just like say something is that, like, even the fact that us youth have to be up here trying to create awareness and make change, I feel is almost kind of wrong, and we shouldn't be having to do this. And then the other thing I want to say is that my Auntie Josephine always had a little quote. She used to say, if you had an idea or a way you could, yeah, like an idea, she'd always just say, just do it. So I just want to say that if you have an idea or a solution or a way you can help us, just do it. So.